this is the third class of time, speed and distance, and in this session I am going to discuss about the concepts of boats and streams. Alright, so we'll see how do we solve questions related to boats and streams. Okay, yes, hi Millie, hi Chaitanya, welcome to the session. Hi Gia. Okay, let's begin. Yeah, so before I start, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Ishwarya and I have done my master's in maths from University of Delhi. Prior to that, I did my graduation in maths from University of Delhi. I've been training students for various exams like CAT, GRE and GMAT since past 4 years now. Yes, good afternoon, good noon everyone. Okay, so now at Unacademy, we provide you two kinds of subscriptions. The plus subscription and iconic subscription. So if you go for the plus subscription, the price of 24 months is 32,800 and for 12 months this price is 22,550. Likewise, the price of iconic subscription for 24 months is 67,000 and for 12 months the price is 39,500. So you can get 10% off the course fee if you use the code AAISH10. Alright, okay. Yeah, so today we are going to discuss about boats and stream questions. So here are certain terms that are often found in boats and stream questions. So let us understand what is the meaning of each and every term. Okay. Yes, Millie, I have seen the questions. I will definitely solve those and share the explanations with you. Okay. Yes, so I will be sending the explanations by the end of the day. Okay. Yes, so can everyone send a hi in the chat box so that I can know who all are attending the session? Okay, let's start. So, see, in questions related to boats and streams, we have a river or a sea or any stream of water that is flowing, okay, and we have a boat. Okay, now it is said that the boat is downstream. Boat is moving downstream if it moves with the current or if it moves with the stream. With the stream means the boat is moving in the same direction as the stream. Okay, so direction in which the river water is flowing is same as the boat. Alright, so this is known as downstream. So when the direction of boat and the stream is same, then it is said that the boat is moving downstream. Alright, likewise we have upstream. Okay, when the boat is moving against the speed of the water, against the speed of the stream, then this is known as upstream. So in this case, boat and stream both are in opposite directions. Alright. In this case, both are in same direction. Okay. I hope these two terms, downstream and upstream, are clear to everyone. Yes. Hi, Manav, Chetna, Kanksha. Good afternoon, guys. Yes. Please confirm if these two terms are clear to all of you. Downstream and upstream. Yes. Okay. Now see, in questions related to boats and stream, it is not necessary that there is always a boat in the water. Okay, there could be a swimmer also, right? There could be a cyclist who is cycling across the wind, okay, against the wind or with the direction of the wind. Alright, so the method to solve all the questions will be exactly same. Okay, so now let us discuss what is the speed of a boat in still water. Still water means water is not moving, but the boat is moving at a certain speed. So this speed is known as the speed of boat in still water. Speed of boat in still water. Okay. Alright. I hope I am clear with these three terms. Okay. Let's see. Now see, when the boat travels downstream, so what do you think what happens to the speed of the boat? Is it increases or the speed of the boat will decrease? What do you think? With the stream. Okay, so when the boat is traveling downstream, then the speed of the stream is added to the speed of the boat. Okay, and when the boat is moving upstream, it means it is moving against the stream, so therefore speed of the boat will decrease. Okay, all right, correct, right Bharat, Sakshi, right answers. Okay, so let us discuss this. So when the boat is moving upstream, the speed of the water opposes the speed of the boat because the directions are opposite. Okay, since the directions are opposite, the speed of the water opposes the speed of the boat. And when the boat is moving downstream, that is with the speed of the water, with the flow, then speed of the water aids to the, thus adds to the speed of the boat. Okay, so this is one concept that you need to understand carefully. Okay, this should be absolutely clear in your mind. Okay, now let us discuss this. So a boat has a speed, these three speeds are there with the boat. Speed of the boat in still water, speed of the boat upstream, speed of the boat downstream. Now let us discuss what is the relationship between these three speeds of a boat. Okay, first one is that upstream speed of the boat is equal to speed of the boat in still water minus speed of the stream. Okay, so upstream speed is, okay, since this opposes, therefore upstream speed of boat is equal to speed in still water minus stream speed, speed of the stream. Okay, likewise the downstream speed of the boat is speed of the boat in still water plus speed of the stream. Okay, this is the downstream speed. Okay, so now what I am going to do is that I am going to take the upstream speed as u and downstream speed as d. Okay, so can I write that u is equal to still water speed, still water speed is speed of the boat in still water minus speed of the stream. Okay, and downstream d is equal to still water speed minus stream speed. Okay, so from here, can I get a relationship between the upstream and downstream speed? What is the relationship between u and d? Can we solve? Let us add these two equations. If I add these two equations, so the stream speed, add these two equations and tell me what will you get? Okay, so we'll get this relationship. So we have upstream speed, let us take it as u, is equal to speed of the boat in still water minus speed of the stream. And downstream speed is equal to speed of the boat in still water plus speed of the stream. So therefore, we can say that speed of the boat in still water is equal to upstream speed plus downstream speed by 2. Yes, correct. So u plus d by 2 is equal to speed of the boat in still water. Correct. Okay. Now, what is the speed of the water current, or you can say speed of the stream? What is this value? Try to solve it. So this will be equal to which speed? Downstream speed minus upstream by 2. Okay. Alright. So still water is u plus d by 2. Speed of the stream is d minus u by 2. So this is the relationship between these three speeds. Yes guys, please confirm if this is absolutely clear in your mind so that we can move to the questions. Yes, everyone, Jia, Chaitanya, Manav, Chetna, Kanksha, Bharat, Sakshi, everyone. Yes, clear? Okay, great. So let us see the first question. So here is the first question. Please read it and try to solve. Okay, so you have 2 minutes to answer, then we'll discuss this together, okay? Okay. once more. Okay, all right Chetna, we'll discuss this. So yes, so I said upstream speed means when the boat travels in opposite direction with the speed of the river. Okay, if boat speed the direction of travel of boat is this and direction of water is this, this is opposite, so this is known as upstream. Okay, if both are traveling in the same direction, this is known as downstream. Okay, so in case of upstream, the speed is speed of boat in still water minus speed of the current or the speed of the stream, and downstream is still water plus speed of the stream. Okay, so this is the relationship. Now from these two relationships, if I take upstream speed as u and downstream speed as d, okay, then you will get this still water speed is u plus d by 2. Eliminate this term, speed of the stream. Okay, and if you eliminate speed in still water, you will get d minus u by 2. Okay, so these are the relationships that you need to know. All right. Okay, now move towards the question. Please solve this. Yes, Chetna, is this clear now? Okay, we have an answer. Okay, let's see. So it is given that a boat travels 300 kilometers upstream in 5 hours. So using this statement, I can calculate the upstream speed of boat. Upstream speed. Okay, let us take it as u, and this is 300 upon 5, right? So which will be equal to 60 kilometer per hour. This is the upstream speed. Now 50 kilometers downstream in 10 hours. So what is the downstream speed? Yes, so downstream speed is equal to d, which is 50 by 10, hence 5 kilometers per hour. Okay, this is the speed downstream and this is the speed upstream. Yes, is this clear? Yes, Naman, this actually this is an application of relative speed concept only. Okay, now find the speed of the boat in still water. So what is the speed of the boat in still water? So still water speed is equal to u plus d by 2, right? So this will be equal to 65 by 2, hence 32 kilometers per hour, 32.5. Okay, correct. Now likewise we can find the speed of the stream. Speed of stream will be equal to, the relationship is d minus u by 2. Okay, so in this case 5 minus 60 by 2, which is equal to minus 55 by 2 kilometers per hour. Alright, I hope this question is clear. Yes, everyone. So, see, generally, what happens is that speed of downstream is always greater than the speed of upstream, because in downstream the speeds are added. And in upstream, the speeds are subtracted, okay? But the numbers in the question are giving this answer, okay? But I hope this is clear. Let's see the next one. Yes, please try this question. You have 2 minutes. Think about it and solve. Yes. Yes, Millie, we can discuss that question today evening. After my classes, I can discuss it with you, okay? Yes, is this question clear to all? Okay, we have one answer, 15 kilometers. Okay, let's see. Yes, everyone, what is the answer? Jia, Chaitanya, Manav, Chetna, Kanksha, Bharat, Sakshi, Naman, everyone, please type in your answers. Okay, let us see how will we solve this question. So Rahul can row 20 kilometers in 2 hours in still water, right? So what is the speed of Rahul in still water? Speed of Rahul in still water. Okay, what is the speed of Rahul in still water? 20 kilometers by 2, that is 10 kilometer per hour. Okay, this is the speed. Now, if the speed of stream is 6 km per hour, speed of stream is also given. Sorry, this is 6 km per hour. Now, he would take 3.75 hours to cover a round trip journey. What does round trip journey means? First of all, going with the direction of the water and then coming back, right? So therefore, round trip means downstream, then upstream, right? Both the cases we need to find. Now we need to find the distance that he will cover in each way. Okay, so the distance that he is going to cover in each trip, it will be same, right? So let us take that the distance is x. Yes, so we have taken that distance is equal to x for one trip. This is the distance for one trip. All right. So let us solve now. So when he moves upstream, what is the speed upstream? What is the value of u? So upstream speed is equal to, let's go back and check the formula. Upstream speed is equal to speed of the boat in still water minus speed of the stream, right? So speed of the speed of Rahul in still water is 10 minus speed of the stream, that is 6. So this is the upstream speed. Now, what is the downstream speed? Speed of the boat, speed of Rahul in still water plus speed of the stream. So this is 10 plus 6. Okay, so what is this value? 4 kilometers per hour upstream speed, and downstream speed is equal to 16 kilometers per hour. Okay, so we have this. So let us see, the total time is given. So time required when he was traveling upstream was equal to x upon 4. The distance, right? And the time taken when he was traveling downstream was x upon 16, right? And the total time is equal to 3.75. So you need to solve this and get the value of x. Please solve for it and tell me what is the final value of x you are getting. 12, okay. So x is equal to 12 kilometers. Yes, so Ranveer, your answer was right earlier. Correct, great. Okay, guys, is this question clear to everyone? Any doubt in this question? Clear? Okay. Last step. Okay, let's see. So see, using these two formulas, these one, upstream speed and downstream speed. Speed of boat is given to us, that is, boat here is Rahul. So speed of boat here is given as 10 and speed of stream is 6. So upstream speed kya aa gaya? 10 minus 6, 4. Downstream speed kya aa gaya? 10 plus 4, that is, sorry, 10 plus 6, that is 16. Okay, distance we have taken as x. So if distance is x, speeds are known, we can calculate the time, x upon 4, other time would be x upon 16, and total time given at 3.75, so just equated, okay, so x 12 kilometers. Alright Chaitanya, I hope this is clear now. Okay, let's see the next question. Yes, please try this one. Alright, we have two answers. Okay, yes, let us discuss. So, Karthik rode a distance of 36 kilometers in still water in 3 hours. So, what is the speed in still water? Okay, speed in still water is equal to 36 by 3. This becomes 12 kilometers per hour. Okay, we have speed in still water. Then he rode 30 kilometers in 2 hours with the current. With the current means downstream. Right? So the downstream speed will be equal to 30 by 2, which is equal to 15 kilometers per hour. Okay, then we need to find the time he would take to row 27 kilometers against the current. Against the current means upstream. Okay, so to find the time, we need the upstream speed. And this is the relationship we have, that the speed in still water is equal to u plus d by 2. Right, we have this, so let us use this concept. Still water speed is given as 12. Upstream we need to find. Downstream is 15. Okay, so solve this and tell me what is the value of u you get. 24 minus 15, this will be 9. So the speed of upstream is 9 kilometers per hour. Okay, now the distance is given as 27 kilometers. Upstream speed is 9 kilometers per hour. So the time taken will be equal to 27 by 9, that is 3 hours. Okay, so 3 hours is the right answer. Yes, correct. All of you gave the correct answers. Great. Okay, let's see the next question. Yes, please try this. 2 minutes to answer. Okay, we have one answer. Let's see. Yes. Hey, Millie, thank you. Okay. Yes, everyone, please type in your answers. Alright, two answers. Okay, let us discuss. So in a certain time, a boat can cover either, in a certain time means the time is fixed. A boat can cover either a certain distance upstream or 7 by 2 times that distance downstream. Okay, so the time here is fixed for both the cases, right? Okay, so let us discuss about upstream and then downstream. Okay, all right. Yes, so boat can cover either a distance upstream. So let us take here the distance covered is equal to d. Okay, let us take it as x because we take the speed as d. Okay, so let us take it as x, that the distance covered is x. In this case, the distance covered will be 7 by 2 into x, right? Downstream. Time is same in both the cases, right? Speed of the current. Okay, so current is speed, or you can say speed of the stream is equal to 6 kilometers per hour. Okay, we have to find the speed of the boat in still water. Okay, so to find the speed in still water, let us find the upstream speed as well. So upstream speed will be equal to, yes, what is the upstream speed? Okay, so this is equal to, what is the formula? Still water speed minus the current speed. So let us take the still water speed as x. Okay, speed of boat in still water. Okay, let us take this speed as s. So this is equal to s minus 6. And the downstream speed will be equal to s plus 6. Okay, but the time is same in both the cases. So the time required for upstream will be equal to distance upon speed, and this is equal to the downstream time as well. So this is 7x by 2 upon x plus 6, s plus 6. Okay, so we can solve for this. X will be cancelled out and you will get s plus 6 upon s minus 6 is 7 by 2. Okay, solve this further. 2s plus 12 is equal to 7s minus 42. Okay, so from here you get 5s is equal to 22 plus 42. This is 54. Okay, so we get s is equal to 54 by 5. Okay, is this clear? Alright, again. Okay, I'll explain this again. So this is, see, it is given that in a fixed amount of time, in a fixed amount of time, a boat can travel a certain distance upstream. So I have taken this distance as x. Okay, ab utne time mein downstream 7x by 2 distance cover kiya hai. Okay, we know that upstream speed and downstream speeds are different. And upstream speed kya hota hai? Speed of still water minus speed of the current. Speed of the current is given as 6 here. So here the speed is, this is upstream speed, s minus 6, and this is the downstream speed, s plus 6. Okay, time in both the cases are same. So I have equated the values of time. Solve this and you will get the value of s as 54 by 5, which is equal to 10.8. Okay, correct. Yes, is this clear everyone? Yes, Millie, is this clear? Sakshi, Naman, everyone? We have kept time as constant. Naman, we have taken time as constant. Time is fixed. Okay. This is actually the time upstream, time taken for upstream, and this is the time taken for downstream, and equated them. Okay. Yes. Next question. Please try this one. All right, so we have two answers, 7 and 7.5. Okay. Okay, one more 7. Alright, let us discuss. So Rohit can row 2 kilometers upstream in 20 minutes. Okay. And return in another 15 minutes. So if this is upstream, it means the return will be the downstream. Right? Okay, this is the upstream, this is downstream. We need to find average speed. What is the formula for average speed? We know that average speed is equal to total distance covered upon total time taken, right? So what is the total distance covered? So he went 2 kilometers upstream, then he came 2 kilometers downstream also. So the total distance covered will be equal to 2 plus 2, right? And what is the total time required? Now see, this is in kilometers, this is in minutes. So I need to convert the minutes to hours, okay? So this is 20 and this is 15. What is the total time? 20 plus 15, which is 35 minutes, right? So this is 20 by 60 plus 15 by 60. Converted the minutes into hours, okay? Alright, so this is my average speed. So what is the total distance? 4 upon, this will give me 35 into 60. Alright, so we get 240 by 35. Kilometers per hour. Hence my average speed will be, this is 48 by 7 kilometers per hour, slightly less than 7. Okay, yes guys, please confirm if this question is clear, everyone. Yes, okay. So all of you who are getting 7 as the answer, answer is actually 48 by 7. Very close to 7, but this is the right value, okay. Hope this is clear. Now let's see another question. Now this is a question for all of you. This is a homework question. Please read the question. Okay, try to understand it. If there is any doubt in the question, please ask right now, but you have to solve it as homework, okay? No, yeah, if it is theta, then since we are getting a definite value, you can write 48 by 7 as the answer, okay? Alright, Naman. Yes, Biradar, am I clearly audible? Is the voice fine? Please try refreshing the page. All good? Okay. So guys, please take a screenshot of this question. So you have to solve this question as homework. So in tomorrow's class, before I start tomorrow's class, I'll discuss this question tomorrow. Okay. So now tomorrow we are going to solve questions related to races. Okay. This is also a topic of time, speed and distance. This will be the fourth class of time, speed, distance. I'm going to discuss about races. Class will be at 4 p.m. Okay. I hope you guys have taken the screenshot. Let's move on. So now, yes. Yeah, so at an academy, since there is one iconic subscription, and if you go for the iconic subscription, you will get personal help from your educator. The educator will focus on your weak areas. You will get regular test analysis and score reports for each and every mock test that you give on the platform. Other management entrance examinations test is also preparation is also done. All the benefits of plus subscription are inclusive. All right. Yes, Chetna, YouTube pay hai. Yes, on the same channel. So now this is the information about the new plus batches that are starting on the platform. So from 19th and 22nd of May, batches are going to start on a plus platform. I have also started a new course of logical reasoning from today itself. So I am going to start everything from the basics. Okay. So these classes are at 1 p.m. daily. Okay. So you can attend this for logical reasoning. Also, a new course on higher mathematics for IPMAT aspirants is going to come on the plus platform from 21st of May. All right. So please, guys, join this course. Yes, tomorrow's class at 4 p.m. Chetna. Yes, so this is an offer that is going on at an academy, that if you take the subscription for 6 months, you will get the subscription for 7 months. So 1 month of subscription is given to you free of cost. Along with that, you have 10% off using the code AAISH10. Now this is the scholarship test that is held every Sunday. Use the code AAISH10 to enroll for the scholarship test. Okay. Now this is ask a doubt feature. So you get 24/7 support. So whenever you are solving, whenever you are studying, if you are stuck in any question, submit the picture on our platform under ask a doubt tab. Our educators will solve it and share the detailed explanation with you. Okay. To take the Unacademy subscription, just subscribe, just install the Unacademy learning app. Select CAT as your goal. If you are a BBA or IPMAT aspirant, then you can select BBA as your category and click on get subscription. Okay. Then you have to use the code AAISH10. Using this, you get 10% off. You also get access to my special classes and special classes of other educators. There are a lot of free quizzes that happen. You can even access them. All right. Name of the Telegram channel. You can send in questions there. And links of all my YouTube and special classes are shared on Telegram. All right. Okay, guys. Thank you so much for attending the session. I hope it was useful for you. We'll meet tomorrow for questions related to races at 4 p.m. Okay. And today, second session of blood relations at 6 p.m. So see you all there. Okay. Thanks for attending. Be safe, guys. Keep practicing.